Get mad, stay mad, make history. That's the slogan for the mad as hell doctors. Now, I met these guys out in Portland, Oregon, at a town hall earlier this year. This group of doctors believes that the public option is doomed. They are demanding single payer, and of course, I'm all for that. But this month, the doctors are taking their call for real health care reform on the road. They're driving a bus to Washington, D.C., and making stops in about a dozen states along the way to rally Americans. Tonight, they are in Tennessee, and joining me now, from Nashville is Dr. Paul Hochfeld, an emergency room doctor in Oregon, and he is mad as hell. You don't look mad as hell, but I think inside you are, doctor. Good to have you with us tonight.
Thanks, Ed. Good to be here.
Well, what's the message? I met you guys out in Portland at the town hall at the that we did out there with KPOJ, and one of the doctors stood up and got after it, and we knew that this was going to happen. But I get a lot of email around the country saying you got to pay attention to these guys. What would you say to the president right now if you saw him? What's the message?
Well, what we're mad about is actually not health care. What we're mad about is that the industry has once again manipulated the public process, the political process, to create and manipulate public policy for profits instead of health. And I think that the industry is just far more powerful within the Beltway than I think even President Obama could even imagine before he was president. And I think he's as much a victim as he is not showing the courage to tell the American public the truth.
Thank you. I'm not alone. I'm finding somebody else saying the same thing I am. I think it's a matter of being very direct with the folks. You say the public option is doomed. Why do you say that?
Well, this is how we're going to fix health care, all right? We're going to mandate that everybody in the country that doesn't have health insurance buy a commercial product that's flawed. That would be health insurance. And if you can't afford it, we'll make you pay slightly more than you can comfortably afford, and the taxpayer will pay the difference. That's fixing health care. Now, the public plan option isn't available until 2013. And if you get your insurance through your employer, then you don't actually qualify for the public plan option. It turns out that employed people are healthier than unemployed people.
Now, Dr. Hochfeld, you see everything as an ER doctor, but this is what the American people are seeing right now when they talk about reform. That is the top five drug companies and the kind of money they're making, the gross profit, $222 billion, and they spend $71 billion on marketing and $32 billion on research. How does that sit with you as a professional doctor? How does that sit with you, those kind of numbers and the resources spent on that?
That's just part of the problem. I mean, it's not just the insurance, it's not just the drug industry. We're spending 20% of all of our healthcare dollars servicing the insurance industry. They add nothing to health, they only add to cost, and they complicate the lives of your providers who are trying to provide you health. And the drug companies are the problem, and the insurance companies are the problem. For me, getting rid of the insurance companies is not just about saving 20% right off the top. It's about having a system in place so that maybe some public health people could make the really important decisions we need to make that gives us health for our health care dollars instead of profits for the industry.
All right, here's the kind of thinking you're up against. This is Tom Coburn, who's a senator from Oklahoma. This is what he has to say on this doctor show he does. Here it is.
When people run across the border, they're running across for specialty care, or they're running across because they got a waiting line so long that they can't get into the Canadian system.
How do you feel about that when you hear stuff like that, doctor?
85% of Canadians are happy with their health care system. We don't even come close.
What kind of response are you getting from people that you're running into across the country making all these stops?
At every rally and at every presentation, we find an absolutely enthusiastic response from people. The people of Minnesota and the people in Wisconsin, they seem to understand that single payer is the only way we're going to be able to afford the moral imperative of universal access without breaking the bank. This is not spend a lot liberals. These are fiscally conservative people that understand that we can't throw more money at our health care system.
Dr. Hochfeld,
this is about doing the efficient thing.
Yeah, no doubt.